Hi everyone, I'm Brandon Case. In today's video, we are going to discuss zk-SNARKs, the tech making Mina the lightest blockchain in the world. Let's start with explaining zero-knowledge proofs, the zk and zk-SNARKs. Have you heard of the children's game, Where's Waldo? It's the illustrated book series where the reader must find Waldo, a character dressed in striped clothes, amongst masses of other characters in a large scene. Well, think of a zero-knowledge proof as a variant of this game. Normally, if I find Waldo, I would just point to him on the page, proving I know where he is, and you, the verifier, could verify my proof is valid by seeing that. This sort of proof leaks information, though. The proof that I know where Waldo is, by me pointing at him, shows you, the verifier, where he is on the page. But what if instead I wanted to convince you I knew where Waldo was, but I didn't want to spoil the game for you? Well, I'd change how I construct my proof. First, I'll get a large piece of paper, much larger than the size of the book. And then I'll place the paper over the book, let's say it's here, and I'll move the book randomly behind the construction paper. And finally, since I know where the book is and I know where Waldo is, I can cut a small hole in the construction paper, revealing Waldo, but not showing any context around Waldo. And this is my proof. Well, this whole thing. Then you, the verifier, would look and only see the construction paper with the hole revealing Waldo. And this convinces you of my proof. You won't know the context around Waldo because the construction paper is covering all the contextual information about who Waldo is next to. This proof doesn't leak any information about Waldo's location. A verifier seeing this proof wouldn't have an easier time finding Waldo than someone who hasn't. We call this a zero-knowledge proof because it leaks absolutely no information to anyone who observes it. The Where's Waldo example explains the concept of zero knowledge, but what about the SNARK part? Well, it's an acronym. zk-SNARKs stands for Zero Knowledge Succinct Non-Interactive Argument of Knowledge. Succinct means that the proofs are small and easy to verify, even if the concept being proven is complicated. Non-interactive means that we don't need a back and forth communication between a prover and a verifier. And this is like in the Where's Waldo example. A prover can hand over the proof, the construction paper contraption, and a verifier can tell if the proof is valid without asking any further questions. Argument is a formalism for talking about these proofs because there is some fancy cryptography and non-determinism that doesn't quite make these formal proofs in the traditional sense, though we can still think of them as such. Finally, the of knowledge part refers to the fact that the prover actually has the evidence themselves. I'm not just proving that Waldo exists on the page, but as the prover, I know where Waldo is. All zk-SNARKs have these properties. They don't leak information, they are tiny and easy to verify, even if the notion being proven is complicated, they don't require back and forth communication, and they are proofs of knowledge. The prover must actually know the thing being claimed, not just that it is true. In Mina, we don't play a game of Where's Waldo. We prove that the entire blockchain is valid. Why does a blockchain need to be valid? Because blockchains are run by many independent people instead of a central entity like a bank. So it's necessary for many people to verify that a blockchain is valid before trusting it. In other chains, folks verify the blockchain is valid by replaying every block one by one by one. In Mina, however, we do this by proving just that there exists a sequence of blocks that form a blockchain. However, rather than revalidating the full sequence of blocks, every time a new block is created, Mina just tweaks the proof statement slightly. Instead, we prove that there was a valid proof for some sequence of blocks, and there's a new extra one that's also valid. In a sense, every time a new block is created and broadcast throughout the network, we extend the proof to support this extra block. This self-referential concept of proofs referring to themselves is fascinating. Think of it like a picture within a picture within a picture, and so on. Certain zk-SNARKs, like pickles that's used in Mina, support a concept known as recursion, that a proof can refer to itself. And doing this doesn't increase the size of the proofs, no matter how many times we refer to ourselves. This recursion concept, this picture in a picture, is what allows Mina to stay small. Now, it's a little more complicated than the picture in a picture. The math behind zk-SNARKs is quite complex, so we won't go over it in this video. But rest assured, this is the sort of thing that SNARKs can do too. In Mina, we hide the complex details of SNARKs behind a nice programming language called Snarky, and you can find more about that in the description below. Mina's zk-SNARKs are groundbreaking because the zero-knowledge proofs allow the blockchain to stay very small and private. Proving where Waldo is on a page may not seem important, but what if you wanted to prove that you had a high enough credit score to apply for a loan without actually sharing your social security number or credit score with the bank? That's cool, isn't it? So that's it for this video. If you found this video interesting, hit the like button and let us know. What's something interesting that you may want to prove with zk-SNARKs? Drop me your comments below, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next video.